Hi there, I would like to show you my standing fan modification. I made it because I didn't like it in flight remote. I always lose it, and because of quite narrow angle, you have to be in front of the control panel. So I added simple web server and the Wi-Fi access point, and I can control standing fan with the web browser from smartphone or notebook. So this is the control panel. I can on off, enable the humidifier, change the speed of the humidifier, enable the oscillations, change the speed, set the timer and the mode. It's like 6 micro switches from the control panel, and I can do the same things from the access point. Just need to connect to the access point. And change the IP address. And like before, humidifier, oscillation, speed. You can use that for the any other device which have a microcontroller with the 5 volts logic. I will show you schematics and the code. So this is how it looks like from the inside. As you can see, no need to modify the main board, just a few wires soldered to the micro switches pins. Two wires over there. You need to be very careful here. Here's a 230 AC volts risk of the electric shock. Two wires are connected to the external power supply. External power supply is needed for the Wemos D1 mini board, because that one on the main board is not enough, and you need two boards of the quad level shifters. Here's a example. Level shifters are needed because Wemos D1 mini board is using 3 volts logic, and microcontroller is using 5 volts logic. And you need a 3 state hex buffer. Part number is CD4503. And yeah, okay, I will show you connections for the pins. Here's the humidifier pin. Here's the on-off pin, oscillations pin, speed, mode, and timer. The ground is here. Okay, don't forget to tape the boards to avoid the electric shock. That's it. So here's the modification schematics. On the left side is the modification modules, on the right side is a standing fan main board PCB. Here are the soldering points which I just show you for the micro switches. And for the power, external power supply is here. Wemos D1 mini board, two level shifters, 3-state hex buffer. 3-state hex buffer is changing high state from the high impedance to normal state if the first output pin D1 is active. And I will show you the code. The code is quite simple. It's maybe 100 lines. You can set up your local network name and password, access point name and password. Here's the map for the Wemos D1 mini board pins. Website is as a string. You can modify color of the buttons, shape of them, number of them, and you can read the output from the serial ports for the debugging. It's very useful for the first run. Okay, I will show you the flashing settings. And try it to reflash again. Here's a function for the twisted hex buffer to control outputs, and also you can have a DNS responder. You can put that address to your browser, not just IP numbers, just that address, and it's working. Okay, I will open the serial port. Now it's connecting to the local network, and local network IP address is that one, and access point address is that one. Server is running. You can check it here. The freeze button, pin number 4, and next one. Timer and the mode. Yeah, all of them are here. That's it. Thank you. I hope you like it.